Outside, it's a freezing Arctic wasteland. But inside, it's loud, hot, and rowdy. Welcome to the Thunderdome. We're broadcasting live from Cinerapolis, Forsk, Minnesota. The fans are wearing parkas and shorts, ready for the carnage to begin. This game is going to be a wholesale slaughter. No discounts in the NFL. The teams storm the field. The Tokyo Terminators take on the Purple Mutant Eaters. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, I scared of a shiver. I am a hell of a fella.
It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's NFL game day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down greased street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
And that'll be second and 8 to go. And he made a mistake. Get back, my friends. Was an all-pro NFL hit. First and 10. And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
Second down and 10. The defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3-yard gain on that pass. And that'll bring up third down and 7. At this rate, the QB's going to have more interceptions than complete. Hey, Bricks, you were hit more than a few times like that in your career.
140 times to be exact. In one game to be more exact. During one play to be more and more exact. It wasn't even a game, actually. Coach just laid into me on the sidelines.
And it's first and 10. Rumbles for 9 on that play. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick 6. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
And it's 1st and 10. They pick up 3 on a short pass. Second down and 7. He's supercharged and can electrocute any opposing. And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division and weep tonight.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? It reminds me, give me that Zappa song. Watch your
biscuits go? Don't you?
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. And it's first and 10. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
What it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. Second down and 2. Running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a first down. And it's first and 10. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. Second down and 9. Keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Third down and 3. Oh, I love this dirty trick. G5. Oh, man, what a throw. That sonic blast just cleared. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And it's first and 10. And there's another pick. And this quarterback must have... Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. First down and inch. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10. That's another turnover for the defense. He dies and fumbles the ball. And no one's going to his shiv after the game. And it's first and 10. Play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Third down and 6. Even had a target on that throw. And they'll line up for the punt here. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. Oh, nice hit. First and 10. Powell with the brain scrambler. And this game is up for grabs. The sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and 5.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Third and 2. Oh, what a sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he put all of his foot into that one. Nice catch, and he turns on the answer.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and 10. Looks like a pass, and it's bouncing right back to the QB. Oh, it's the sticky ball dirty trick.
Ah, pass the popcorn, Grim. Zoom in on his face, then his crotch. I want to see if he cries or pisses himself first.
Second down in a very lot. Great run for a 9-yard gain. Third down and, well, good luck. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice pick. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and 10. first meets the explodable object. And it's first and 10. Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it. He scores!
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Shithouse. And oh man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye?
Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. First and 10. And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
And that'll bring up second and 1. Man, what a hit that was. Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the NFL. And it's first and 10. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
Didn't see it. At least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And the offense has only 2 running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last 2 runners for this outman.
And it's first and 10. Play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big peregrine. You're right.
Oh, he was hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. Oh, did he take a punishing hit. You ever had your lights knocked out like that, Bricks?
Yeah, the waitress at the Boo Hooters chicken wings last night? Oh, yeah, and then the police horses out front in the stadium earlier. It was just a joke slap, but the horse took it seriously.
Not surprised. And he like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. And that'll be second and eight to go. The nastiest dirty trick in the NFL. Send a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger because he's gonna kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message because the messenger killed him. Ah, I'm going in circles.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the...
And he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
And these guys are not giving the quarterback many passing lanes to hit a receiver. Nice block by the defense there. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. That's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds.
Well, that's two timeouts burned, and you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Grin, but it really is hard to do both at the same time, and I have mastered it.
The punter for today is being played by my kid's sister, and he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the tackle, and he bursts into the end zone for the score. What a run! With moves like that, you know he's got a screw loose. Handyman out there? Somebody? Drill? Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good! They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. First down. The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Yeah, who don't do that?
Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick.
Hey, a Sawbuck says he misses.
Straight through the uprights. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsanto Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. Quarter about to begin here, and these guys are locked in a nearly dead heat.
I was locked in a dead heat under the covers last night when Brick started farting like a 4th of July fireworks finale.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and 10. for 6 yards. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Third and four. Revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Yeah. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go.
That's the way to keep the chains moving.
And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. And it's 1st and 10. Second down and 5. And he reels that one in for a 1st down to keep the drive alive. First and 8 to go. It should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? TR pass play, and that's not going to get it done. The offense needs to move the ball upfield. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Oh, the punishing hit. The quarterback goes down. Warming up.
If I was that QB, I'd be pissed.
Now, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he's got a chance for a good return here. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. And he throws that one to the sidelines. First down and forever. I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. It's first and 10. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
First and 8 to go. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
Yeah, big deal. Missed a beat for Brains, ran with a ball, didn't fall down.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right.
And here comes the extra point attempt. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
And the Purple Mutant Eaters just made the competition today and deliver their home team fans a forfeit.
Grim, some of the defensive Mutant Eater players are snacking on the leftover body parts.
Why do you think they're called the Purple Mutant Eaters, you idiot?
There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game.
How about if you shut the hell up right now and we go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say? Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Heart Corporation. They get it right every up.